सद्गुरुदेव महाराज की, बाबा भूमन शाह देव महाराज की जय। जगत गुरु श्री चंद्र भगवान की, सच्चिदानंद भगवान की जय। अ वेरी लविंग हरिओम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज ऑफ बिलवड गुरुदेव लिविंग अब्रॉड। इट्स रियली वेरी लॉन्ग since I talked to you through the YouTube. I hope and pray that all of you are well, healthy and happy. Many, many holy greetings on the auspicious day of Guru Purnima, which falls this year just after a few days on the 24th of July. May Gurudev's blessings be always upon you. May His grace always propel you, enlighten your paths, and hold your hands here and hereafter. The health of Pujya Gurudev is reasonably fine, according to his age, even though he has become weaker physically, and understandably so, as I have been telling in my previous messages. He, without fail, attends to all his daily routine, gets up like before early morning, before 3 o'clock, attends the morning meditation with all of us, and sings at 11:30 with his devotees, with ashramites daily, takes lunch with all of us down in the common lunch place, and without fail goes to the cows. But now he goes on wheelchair and comes back, and then goes straight away to the evening meditation. He does it daily without fail, which is so amazing and inspiring. He is happy and cheerful, and he showers his grace upon all of us. As for the ashram opening, I am obliged to inform that still we have to keep it closed. As per the advice of the well-wishers, and after inquiring so many sources, they all advise that a public place like ashram should be kept closed for more time. And we also hear that the third wave could also hit. Although in India the cases are down, but they are sticking around 40,000 for the last about 15 days. So we will not take any chance, and the ashram will remain closed. And as for the foreign devotees, Government of India has not started the visa also. But even if the visas are issued, the ashram will take its call depending upon the circumstances here. Also, we have to bear it in mind, people who are coming from that far off and from the places where the medical facilities are so up to date. We are in a very small village where hardly any medical infrastructure, in case of emergencies I am talking about. So it will be prudent to still wait for more time for coming to the ashram. Although we would love to be with all of you, it has been really long, and so many my brothers and sisters living abroad, their life and their spiritual routine is so inspiring. It's a great joy to have them in our ashram. So we will be waiting when it will happen. Presently there are few Indian devotees which we have called for the ashram work. The ashram, it's a big place, and so we have calls. Recently a full truck load of the wheat and other rations have arrived from Rajasthan. The devotees have collected it So many people have come with the truck. Plus we have called other devotees also. We quarantine them for a week or so, and then for a small period, according to what suits us, we allow them in the ashram. So, but very, very few. We hope that some 10-15 devotees will be there during the Guru Purnima celebration also. And we will celebrate the Guru Purnima as every year. We will do the holy aartis of Gurudev, Baba Bhuman Shahji, Bhagwan Shri Chandraji, chantings in the meditation hall. We will do the holy havan, sacrificial fire ceremony also in the morning. Many staff members have been living in the ashram for now about 1.5 years. And since we have been doing so much repair and maintenance work in the ashram, which we could not do in the last 20 years, so they have served the ashram with exemplary devotion and the love of Gurudev. So they will be, so we will be more than 100 people on that day, because all the staff members living within the safety walls of the ashram, they will be participating in the Guru Puja function. We will do some charity also. I'm also glad to inform you that we have been doing the charity of in many ways during the second wave of the corona also, according to our means. We are honored and privileged to do that also. About Guru Purnima, I would say it is the most sacred day that visits every year every disciple. It is a day of deep gratitude. It is a day of expressing our gratitude for being twice born into the spiritual life. It is a day of gratitude to Gurudev for his having enlightened our way, for holding our hand onto the unknown, very, very difficult spiritual path. So I hope that you all celebrate it in your own ways at your home. The two most important things of expressing gratitude to Gurudev is to follow his teachings wholeheartedly, what he has taught us. And the two important teachings within that are to remember God, to do our regular sadhana, and the another is to serve the poor and needy for the pleasure of Guru and God. So I wish that you will celebrate, you will do the aarti of Gurudev at your homes. You might gather if you are living with your guru sister or guru brother close to you, and you may do chanting, reading from Gurudev's books, or doing any, you may do the special sadhanas, special japa chanting, meditation, whatever, in the love of Gurudev. I wish you a very, very happy Guru Purnima. It is a full moon day. May his blessings be always with you. May all of you grow spiritually, be more and more close to the spiritual light of Guru and God. A very loving Hari Om from all of us who are sitting here. All the ashramites, this send their love to you all. Hari Om. बोलिए सद्गुरुदेव महाराज की जय. बाबा भूमन शाह देव महाराज की जय. जगद्गुरु श्रीचंद्र भगवान की जय. सच्चिदानंद भगवान की जय.